In this video, now we'll learn more about these types of synthetic fibers. We have learned that through the two activities of beads forming a necklace and a long chain which is formed by the paper pins. So we can say that synthetic fibers are also formed due to the smaller chemical units which are joined repeatedly to form a longer chain, that is the polymer. Now we will see in detail the types of synthetic fibers. So let us start with the first, that is rayon. Now you have already learned in the class 7 that silk fiber obtained from the silkworm, and that was discovered in China and was kept closely guarded secret for a longer time. Fabrics obtained from the silk fiber was very costly, but its beautiful texture fascinated everybody. Attempts were made to make silk artificially, and towards the end of the 19th century, scientists were successful in obtaining a fiber having properties similar to that of the silk, and that is the rayon. This fiber was obtained by chemical treatment of wood pulp, and this is the artificial silk, which is also known as the rayon. Although rayon is obtained from natural source, that is wood pulp, yet it is man-made fiber. It is cheaper than silk and can be woven like silk fibers. It can also be dyed in a wide variety of colors. Rayon is mixed with cotton to make bed sheets or mixed with wool to make the carpets. So the carpets, bed sheets which you use at your home, keep in your mind that they are made up of the rayon. This is what about a synthetic fiber known as the rayon. Next synthetic fiber is the nylon. Nylon is another man-made fiber, or the artificial fiber and the synthetic fiber. In 1931, it was made without using any natural raw material. That is, to make this, the sources like plants and animals were not used. It was prepared from the coal, water and air, and therefore it is first fully synthetic fiber, which was made without using any natural sources like plants and animals. Therefore, it is known as fully synthetic fiber. And this was the first fiber which was made without using any natural raw material. These nylon fibers are very strong. They are elastic. If you will see the strongness of these fibers, then they are stronger than the steel wire. They are elastic, as well as they are light in weight, as well as they are lustrous, and they are easy to wash. And therefore, it become very popular for making clothes. As well as rayon is used for making socks, rope, tents, toothbrush, car, seat belt, then sleeping bags, curtains, parachutes, ropes for rock climbing, because of the properties of the nylon. To understand the strongness or to test the property, let us perform a small activity. For that, take an iron stand with a clamp. Take a cotton thread of about 60 cm length. Tie it to the clamp so that it hangs freely from it, as shown in this figure. At the free end, suspend a pan so that weight can be placed in it. Add weight one by one till the thread breaks. Note down the total weight required to break the thread. This weight indicates the strength of the fiber. Repeat the same activity with threads of wool, polyester, silk, and nylon, and tabulate the data as shown here in the figure. So to do this activity, we have taken four types of threads, or you can call them as the fiber, like cotton, wool, silk, and nylon. In the pan, we are going to add the weights till that thread will get breaked. Here, in this activity, we are going to check the strength of these threads or the fibers. Now, make sure that when you are performing this activity, take all the threads of the same length and almost of the same thickness. And just add the weight and observe the things and write it down. At the end, you will notice that the weight required to break the threads of wool, silk, and nylon is more than the cotton. Here, we can say that therefore synthetic fibers are stronger than the cotton.